we'll get started. So basically, we're gonna do everything to calm down the breathing, just recover your body. We're doing a lot of high intensity training, a lot of squats, lunges, core, plyometric stuff. So now we just need to calm everything down and prevent any injuries, because we're quite high risk at the moment. We're doing different things. If you can't go out to run, we're trying new things. So it's really important to recover. So we're gonna get the roller. You're gonna start with the quads, both sides. So bring the foam roller down in front of you. We're gonna put just above the knee on the right leg. Walk the hands down in front of you. Rest your leg there, your left leg out, comes out to the side as a hinge. I'll show you this way. And you're just gonna roll from your hip above your kneecap. So you don't hit the joints, you just roll up and down the muscle. Use your arms as levers, use your leg as a lever. Just keep a fluid movement. I'm so glad you're doing this. I know I'm making you do it, guys. Good, just keep moving up and down. If you feel a point that's quite tender, you can hold there and you bend and straighten your leg, okay? Put the knee down if you need to and then we roll. Good, keep going, stay with me. Okay, so we're still on the quad. You're gonna get just underneath your hip bone. You turn onto your side. We're gonna roll up and down a little bit there. So imagine your pelvis, the arch in the side of your hip. You're kind of in that cushiony bit, in the soft tissue. And from there, we're gonna lean forwards, put the hand down, the left arm. You open up, rock backwards, rock forwards, and backwards. And breathe, bear with me. So you're opening the chest, you're rolling the hip. Good, then you come back on your stomach. A few more rolls up and down. Good job. Good, come back through the center. We change sides, so we're onto the left leg. So just above your kneecap, right leg comes out to the side. You just roll down and up. So in between your hip joint and your kneecap. Nice and fluid. So you're getting all the oxygenated blood to the muscle. We're stretching out the deeper muscle fibers. Good, keep going. I'm sure you're pulling faces at me right now. Again, if you find a tender point, put your knee down, bend, straighten, bend, straighten, breathe. Good, and then you roll it out. We go to the hip. So you're just inside the arch of your hip bone. We roll up and down. Your right leg's still a hinge. Then you hold it there. Open up the arm, rotate backwards. Roll forwards. Rotate on the leg as well, so you're in the cushiony bit on the inside of your hip. You're not on the bone. Smile, it makes it all better. Once more. Good, and just roll up and down. Flush out the toxins, the lactic acid, and we're up onto our knees. Next up, adductors, so your inner thighs. The foam roller, it doesn't matter what kind you have, by the way. We bring it down vertically in front of you. Bring your hands down. The inside of your knee comes onto the roller, down onto your forearms, and you just roll out to the side, back in. Breathe. We're gonna feel this, you need it. Then as we come to the top of the hip here, Your arms are down and you straighten and you bend your leg at the knee. So you can rest your back leg down, you bend and straighten. Are we happy? I can see some waves, I can see some happy faces, some not so happy faces. Good job, guys. Good, then lift up again. We roll in, we roll out, down the adductors. Good, then slowly up onto your knees. Have a minute, breathe. We change sides, okay? So the inside of your left knee is on the roller. You'll walk down onto your forearms and tuck the back foot, lift the knee, and we roll out. Good job. Breathe. Please don't be holding your breath. Then we hold at the top of the hip, at the top of the groin, and we bend and straighten the leg. So we bend and straighten. You're stretching the tissue, but you've got the pressure on the fascia. Good work, guys. Good, then we lift up. We're going to do a couple more rolls. And then slowly use your core back up onto your hands and your knees. Next up, we're gonna do a stretch with the roller. So the roller comes behind you. You rest your feet. Ooh, I'll just step back a bit. You rest your feet on the roller, so your ankles are there. The roller isn't directly under your ankles, it's slightly more under the top of your foot. Sit back onto your heels if you can. First of all, we hold there, breathe. You're stretching your quad, you're stretching out the front of your ankles. Then, if you can, you're gonna hold onto the roller, lean back. If you can, you reach for the floor and you hold it there, breathe. We're stretching the quads, we're stretching the ankles. Look up to the ceiling, relax the neck, the shoulders. If you need to come back up, do so. If not, we hold, smile and breathe. Good. Have a sit back up. Whilst we're here, we're gonna stretch the feet. So remove the roller, tuck your toes, sit back onto your heels if you can. Stretching out the fascia. If you need to come out and come back up, do so. If not, try and hold it there. Whilst we're here, we're just gonna do some shoulder rotations. Backwards, lift up and back. Remember to come out of that stretch if you need to. Then we lift up, forwards, really emphasize that curve of the spine. Breathe. Good, and we're gonna go to the neck. So you tuck your chin, you rotate, come back around, nice and slowly. Gentle rotations, your feet are still tucked, come back out of it if you need to. And change direction. Good, shake it out. We're coming back onto the roller. We're gonna do the hamstrings, the calves, the back, and then the feet. So sit onto your bum. The roller comes underneath your calves. Start with the roller underneath your ankles, so by your Achilles tendon. You're gonna bring your hands behind you, lift up. We're gonna rock gently, so not all the way up the calf, just halfway. You're gonna rotate your feet out, then you're gonna turn them in. So you're in the silly layer. Either side of your Achilles. If you need to sit down, come back out of it, do so. Just keep rotating the feet. Release those ankles. Breathe. Good, put the bum down. Bring the roller a little bit further up the calf, so the mid calf into the belly of the muscle. Hands behind you, lift the bum up, and we rock forwards and backwards again. OK, Keep rocking gently. You need to put your bum down, shuffle down. Do so again, turn the feet out, turn the feet in. We'll turn both feet to the right, both feet to the left. Keep rotating. We all need this, guys. I'm so proud that you're all joining in. Good, so keep turning the feet in and out. Put your bums down, keep the left leg on, bring the right leg across. If this is too much pressure, stay where you were. Lift up the bum, and we rock forwards and backwards again. Woohoo! You're gonna feel it. I feel it. I'm glad I'm teaching this, making me do it. Good job, guys, keep going. Okay, if you find a sore point here, you hold still and you flex and point your toes, or put your bum down and you rotate. In and out, you cross friction the muscle. Whichever feels like a better release for you, do that. I'm gonna point and flex my toes. Well done, guys. Okay, roll it out, bum goes down, chain side. So right leg's on, left leg crosses over, hands behind you, lift your bum up. Oh, there we go, and we roll. Bit of a shoulder workout as well for you here. When you find that sore point, you'll know, point your toe, flex your foot, point your foot, flex your foot. Keep going. It's a great release. Really good for your ankle mobility. Good. Then back into the normal rolls. Don't go directly behind the knee joint. You're just going in the muscle. Okay. Bum goes down. Shake out the shoulders. And we go to the hamstrings. Right leg's on. Left leg crosses over. Arms behind you. Same process. Lift the bum. Keep the core strong. We roll up and down, forwards and backwards. Again, turn your leg out, turn it in, so you're getting the middle fibers, the outside, the lateral fibers, the medial fibers. Just keep rolling through. Hamstrings and our glutes are where the power comes from. You need to make sure they have all the right nutrients. Good. Are we happy? I hope we're happy. Painful happy. Bum goes down, change sides. So just above the back of the knee, right leg crosses over, lift up the butt, and we roll to just underneath your glutes, up and down the hamstring, outside, the middle, and the inside. Remember, if you need to put your bum down, take a minute, that's absolutely fine. You probably feel one side a bit more than the other as well, that's totally normal. Good, okay, feet come down, roll is here, lift up your bum, kick the roller back with your heels, and you sit on top. We're gonna roll into the glutes, into your butt cheeks. So to start with, hands down and you're just gently rocking forwards and backwards underneath the bum. Keep the core strong, try not to slip. Now from here, you're gonna have your right hand down, your right ankle crosses over the left knee, shift onto your right butt cheek a bit more, left hand on your knee, and you just roll forwards and backwards into the glutes, your glute med. Might feel a bit nervy, that's okay. You hold it there, bring your knee towards you, push your knee away. Bring your knee towards you, push your knee away. Twice more. Good job, guys. Good, we roll it out. We uncross the legs, have a sit on the roller, have a minute, and we change sides. So, the left ankle crosses over the right knee. Your left hand's down on the side. You shift onto
your bum cheek, and you just roll gently forwards and backwards. Hold it still, then you bring your knee towards you, push your knee away. Bring the knee towards you, push the knee away. Keep your hands down for your lower back. Shift onto the right. Shift onto the left. Keep working through. Keep your core strong so you're not arching your back here. You're keeping everything nice and tight. Good. We go to the mid back. So from here up. You lean on the roller. Keep your core strong. Hands come behind your head to support your neck. Lift your bum up, keep your tummy strong. And we roll down and up. Breathe. Tilt onto the right side. Tilt onto the left side. Keep going. Breathe. Remember to keep your core nice and strong. Don't arch your back. You shouldn't get any lower back pain here. You should just feel the release in the muscles. Good, then you roll to your mid-back. Put your bum down, hands come behind your head. Girls, if you have your bra strap, you put the foam roller under there. If not, guys, it's the mid, upper back underneath your shoulder blades. You tuck it in, you breathe out. You lean backwards, keep your bum on the floor, open up your chest, breathe in. Tuck your chin to your chest, breathe out. Good, once more. In, and we breathe out. Good, and we lift up. Okay, arms come back down, use your core, lift yourself up. We just have one more with the roller. We're gonna do your shins, okay? So the foam roller comes in front of you, just below your knee. Hands come down, right leg's out, and you just tuck your knee. Bring your bum up, tuck your knee, bring your bum up. So you're in the muscle on the outside of your shin. So you're not on the bone, you're down the outside, okay? Off we go. So you tuck your knee in. If you have shin splints, if you have problems with your ankle, it's really good to release this muscle. It's quite overactive, especially if you heel strike. Good. And we change sides. So right leg comes on, underneath the knee, outside of your shin. Tuck your knee, bring your knee out. Tuck your knee, bring your knee out. Good job. Who feels this? Ooh, I do. Good, okay. Foam roller can go to the side, good job. If you have a ball, anything this kind of size, tennis ball, golf ball, whatever you've got handy, we're gonna put this on the floor, and then 1 foot at a time, you're gonna roll, putting a bit of pressure down, forwards and backwards, underneath the arch of your foot. We wear trainers, our feet are closed in. We wear the best trainers. Obviously, we need to release that fascia. This is the best way to do it. So roll. Good job, guys. You can push your heel, cross friction again, so you're coming sideways, in, out. Shake it all about. Roll under the arch again, you come to the toes. You're pushing down, across each of your toes. You're gonna feel great after this, I promise you. Good, and you roll forwards and backwards again. Couple of ankle rotations. And we change sides. So
So left foot, whichever foot you didn't do, you're pushing down under the arch, so under the curve in your foot, pushing down. Good job. We get to the heel, so your heel's pushing down, you're coming across. Then you come to your toes, so you push your toes down and rotate through them. Then you come back through the arch of your foot. Good, step off. Few rotations. Ooh, release the cracks. Get your balance. Okay. Balls down. We're ready to stretch. We can slow it all down. Stick with me. I'm sure you're doing amazing. Okay. Have a step back. You're just going to reach both arms up. Clasp your hands. Push your hands to the ceiling. Right leg behind your left. Lean to the left. Feel a nice deep stretch in your rib cage. Breathe in and out of your belly here. We come back through the center and cross your legs. Left leg becomes behind your right. Lean to the right, look to the left. Feel a really good stretch down the left side of your torso. And breathe, open up the chest. Good, we come back through the center. We're just gonna open and close the chest. So give yourself a hug, open. Hug and open, just let the momentum swing the arms around, step side to side. We're trying to move the whole body. Keep going, just let it all release. Good, shake it out. Raise the right arm, we're gonna stretch the triceps, left hand comes to the elbow. If you can, pick up your roller, reach for it, and you're gonna pull down with the arm, down and back. Feel a stretch in the tricep. If not, you just stay here. Good. Hold it here. Good, release. Shake it out and we change sides. So your left arm reaches up, you bend the elbow, right arm comes behind, you reach for the roller and you pull down and back. So this is an assisted stretch with your foam roller. Stretch the triceps. Nice Adidas. Good. Cross your arms. Shake it out. We go to the hips. So hips are a bit more than hip width apart. Hands on your hips and we're going to draw a big circle. So you're coming all the way around. You're not just moving your upper body. We're not dancing. We're doing a big circle. So you're pushing your bum backwards, around, forwards. Really emphasize this big circle you're drawing. Stretch out your hip flexors, your adductors, your hamstrings. Really good hip opener. We change sides. Good. Now we shuffle the feet out a bit more. From here, we're just gonna hinge forward. So you push your bum back, reach your arms forward. Come on, for me. Up. Down, keep your back straight, back up. So your bum goes back, your back straight, you're not curved or arched. Back up, squeeze the glutes. Good, twice more. Really good hip opener, really reach, stretch for me, come on. You can do it. Back up, once more. Breathe. Good. Legs are still apart. We're just gonna lunge onto the right leg. Arms come up. We change sides. So you're stretching the adductors, If you can, use the arms in your running motion. Really, really good hip opener. Nice, guys. Okay, back through the center. Shake it out again. We're gonna go to the mat now. We're gonna take it down to the ground. You'll be happy. So starting at the back of your mat, from here, you're just gonna tuck your chin to your chest. We're gonna slowly fold down. Hang over your legs, clasp your elbows, bend the knees and just sway gently side to side. Relax the neck, the shoulders, nod your head, shake your head. Good. Then we walk our hands forward into a plank position. From here, you can lower yourself down or you put your knees down and lower your chest to the floor. You reach out with the left arm. Your right arm and right leg, lift up and over. Rest your cheek on the floor so you're not straining your neck. Feel a really nice shoulder stretch and breathe here. Then you slowly come back onto your stomach. We change sides, so reach out with the right arm. Your left hand, left leg, reaches up and over. Rest the cheek on the floor. Breathe. Slowly and twisting, come back through the center. We're gonna put our hands by your rib cage. Lift your chest up, rock gently, side to side. Stretch out the hip flexors, try not to dip into your shoulders. Keep your chest tall. Rock side to side. Good, then we hold still. You lift the bum. Bring your feet together, your knees mat width apart. You sit all the way back into child's pose. Reach the hands forwards. Rest your head on the floor. Sit back onto your heels. And breathe. Walk your hands across to the right. So both hands to the right. Look under your left arm. Feel the stretch down the side, your bum still on your heels. Then slowly walking your hands back through the center, across to the left. Spread your fingertips, look under your right arm, rest your head on the floor. Hands come back through center. You come up onto your hands and knees. We're going to do a couple of cat camels. So you tuck your navel to your spine, tuck your chin to your chest, push up through your arms. Then we reverse, you slowly breathe out, push your hips to the ceiling, look to the ceiling. Breathe in, bring your belly button to your spine, tuck your chin to your chest, push through the shoulders. Reverse, arch the back, bum to the ceiling, look up to the ceiling. Good. Back through the center. Shake it out. You step both feet back into a plank position. You hold it here. Then take a big step forward with the right leg outside your right hand. Back knee goes down. Front foot turns out slightly. Hand comes to your knee. You push on the knee gently for the stretch. In your adductors, hold it there. I'm just gonna turn this around as I place you, it might be better. Good. So we're opening the hips, the adductors. Look over your right shoulder. Then let go of the knee, the foot comes to face the front again. Hands come down inside of your foot, back knee lifts up. Come down onto your forearms if you can. If not, stay here. And we're just going to hold this hip stretch. Back knee goes down. We slowly lift up from here. Both of your arms are out in front of you. So you're dipping into the hip and you're just gonna open, rotate to the right. You come back through the center. We do the same again, twice more. Look over your right shoulder. Forwards, don't keep your shoulders up here, they're down, they're relaxed. You open, you close, good. You stay in this position. You're gonna sink a bit further forwards into the hip stretch. Keep your knee in line with your ankle. Then we raise both arms, okay? Smile at me, we're good. Really good hip openers, great for runners. Keep those shoulders away from the ears. If you can, you can untuck the back knee, sink a bit further. If not, we stay here. Good, now from here, you're gonna bring the arms down, you're gonna rock backwards, you're gonna reach down to the mat, straighten your right leg, your toes are flexed, then we hinge forward again, and we lift up, breathe. We're gonna do a few like this. So we sit back, arms come down, foot's flexed, feel the shakes. Lift up, sink into the hips. Sit back, toe comes up. Good, next one. We lift up, the right arm comes down. Reach up and over with the left. Good, we lift back up onto the knee. Hands come back down either side of the front foot and tuck the back. Take a big step back to plank. Push the hips to the ceiling. Put all those heels down. One at a time, stretch out the calves. Good, then we fold over into a plank again. Ripple through the spine. We take a big step forward with the left foot this time. Back knee goes down. We turn the front foot out. Left hand comes to the knee. And you open up the hip, hold it there. So your left foot's forward, you're pushing on the knee, opening up the hips, the adductors. Feels good, hey? Let go of the knee gently, turn the foot to face forward. Hands come inside your foot, untuck the back foot, lift the knee. Come onto your forearms if you can, if not, stay with me here. Feel the stretch in both hips. Put your back knee down whenever you need to. Good, then slowly put the back knee down. We use our core, we lift up. You're gonna sink forwards into that hip flexor stretch. We rotate the thoracic spine. So arms come up, parallel. We rotate with the left arm, look over your left shoulder. Come back through, twice more. Breathe and keep the shoulders down. Good, once more. Good, we shake out the arms, then we lift up. So we raise both arms, sink a bit further into that hip stretch. Nice and strong hands, strong arms, warriors. Good, then you sit back onto that right leg, the left leg straightens, your toes are flexed, feel the stretch down the left leg. Bend the knee if you need to. You're bringing your chest to your knee. And we rock forwards, we lift up, we sink into the hip. Good, hinge backwards. Toes are flexed, hamstrings and calves stretch. We rock forwards and we lift up once more. Sit back, chest to your knee. Good, we rock forwards and we lift up. Again, from here, you rest the left arm, right arm reaches up and over. If you want to, you can lift up the back knee, deeper stretch here, or you can stay down. Good. Now we sit up, bring those arms back down either side of the front foot, and tuck the back foot, lift the knee, step that left foot back to plank, bum to the ceiling again. Stretch out those calves, pedal the heels down. Then we hold our feet still. We raise the right leg and bend it to the left. Look under your left arm, feel the stretch in the right hip. Then we sweep that knee forward behind the right wrist towards the right side of the mat so it's not directly in front of you, it's out to the side. Come down onto your forearms if you can. Rest your head on the floor if you can, or stay here. So your knee is out to the side, it's not here. You feel a stretch in your right glutes, your butt. It's a really good hip opener. We're going to hold this here for a few breaths. Back up onto the forearms, onto the hands, and tuck the back foot, lift the knee. Take a big step back with the right foot, bum to the ceiling for the last time. Pedal those heels down a bit further now. Then we hold the leg still together, lift the left leg, bend it over to the right, stretch out the left hip. And we sweep that left knee forwards, behind the left wrist to the left side of the mat. Your back leg's nice and relaxed. Down onto the forearms, onto your hands, or stay up here. As long as you feel it here, you're doing it right. Good job, guys. Back up onto the forearms, onto the hands, and tuck the back foot, lift the knee, left leg comes to meet the right leg, and we take a jump through, and then sit down on your bum. Your feet are together, so feet are together, shuffle your bum to your heels, hold onto your feet, gonna lift the chest up. I don't want to see this, I can't see you, I know, but don't be doing this. You're gonna keep nice, strong posture. Push those knees down and lift that chest up. Hope you're all doing well. I hope you're staying with me. Breathe. If you need to ease out, then go back in, do so. Okay, let go of the feet. You're gonna straighten the right leg on a diagonal. So it's out to the side. Your left foot is to your thigh. You're gonna reach for your foot if you can, if not, hand on your shin. You're gonna pull yourself down towards your knee, rotate to the left, and left arm comes up and over as you feel the stretch in your QL, your deep low back, and your hamstring. Hold it here. Right shoulder. Feel the stretch in the glutes. Really good for your digestive system, for your glutes, for your hips. Keep tall, no slouching. Good, then we untwist to the left, arms come round. Derotate the spine, uncross the legs, no more pretzels. We straighten the left leg and a diagonal, your right foot comes to your thigh. You reach for your foot if you can, all this side works. You rotate to the left, your arm comes up and over, and you feel the stretch in the hamstrings, the calf, and your lower back. Breathe here, we're nearly done, guys. Shin wherever you were. Your left leg now crosses over the right leg. You're in that nice twist. Right arm hooks your knee to your chest. Left arm comes behind you. Keep your chest tall. Look over your left shoulder. Breathe, feel the stretch in your glutes. You're gonna feel amazing at the end of this, guys, I promise you. Twist to the right, derotate the spine, uncross the legs. We're going to lower down onto our back so your feet are down, arms in front of you. Slowly lower one vertebrae at a time, starting with your lower back. Last bit being your head to the floor, keep your core strong. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Good. Straighten both legs out in front of you. Now one at a time, you're gonna bring your knees into the chest. So right knee comes in, left knee comes in. Rasp your hands around your shins. We're gonna rock gently side to side. Give yourself a big hug. Good, now you're gonna let go with the arms. You keep your legs up and you just let your knees fold to the right. Feel a nice twist here. Look over your left shoulder. Close your eyes. Then with your top leg first, you bring your leg back to center. Your knees are still bent. Your lower back's pushed into the floor. We hug our knees into the chest again. Big hook. Push your lower back to the floor. Rock gently side to side. Close the eyes. We gently let go of the arms. Knees are bent. And you rock over to the opposite side. Your knees come down. Look over your right shoulder. You feel a nice spinal twist.
Thank you. then slowly lift your legs back up to center again, lowering one foot down at a time. Straighten both your legs. Last stretch here, we're gonna lift up both arms. Reach through the fingertips, point your toes, hitch each hip one at a time. Take a big breath into your belly and let it go. Let's do that twice more, big breath in. Just let it all go. All the stresses of the day, let it out. Good, then gently bringing your arms back down by your side. Your feet are relaxed, your hips are relaxed, so your feet are falling out, your palms are facing up. Tuck your chin slightly to your chest, close your eyes, and we're gonna take a few moments here. Think of something you're grateful for right now in this chaos that we're in. Bring some calm to your body. Think of everything you're grateful for. There's so much positive happening amongst all of this as well. Good, then we're gonna make a fist with our hands. Clench your hands really tight. Point your toes, scrunch your feet. Tense your legs, and on three, we're gonna let it all go really quickly. Release everything. One, two, three. Good. Good job. In your own time, guys, have a sit up. We are done with the stretch, with the recovery today. I hope you all enjoyed it. Any questions, please let me know. If you have any issues, any pain, just send me a message. Hopefully we can help you. We're home team. We are here for all of you. But yeah, thank you everyone for joining. I hope you feel great now. You can just chill depending where you are in the world.